We follow with the next case. First, without comment. Okay, first I have a question. What would your first impression, first diagnosis, if this patient would not have any complaints, she would be euthyroid, no pain, no tenderness, and you will faced with this pattern in the rital. What would your first impression? How to guess? Some guess?
Thyroiditis.
Okay.
Thyroiditis, maybe.
Okay. I could not deceive you because I tried to deceive you. This patient had minor tenderness, but this is clearly a very specific pattern of thyroiditis. But if we see the transverse view, this one, a papillary cancer could present in this form. So the transverse scan is always inferior or almost always inferior to the longitudinal scan, because much greater part of a lesion is presented in the longitudinal scan. So this is a very specific pattern of thyroiditis, and this patient had some tenderness in her right thyroid. She was presented in my order that she has a very suspicious thyroid 5 lesion. Therefore, I performed aspiration cytology, which resulted in subacute thyroiditis. Now let's see the borders of this lesion. I think it is quite clear that this lesion has partly blurred, partly lobulated margins. But such irregular margins, the lobulations, are or should be related only to true nodules and not fields of thyroiditis. So the thyroid system, all thyroid system, relates only to nodules and not to thyroiditis. So the classification of nodules has only meaning in the thyroid system and not the classification of thyroiditis. But if we misdiagnose this pattern, this would be a thyroid 5 lesion. Questions related to this case?
I have one question.
Yes?
If it would be so if it's only on one side,
yes.
So it's not bad.
Yes, I will ask you. I will answer your question by demonstrating this case on the website. So now you see around 12 images. Yes? Please answer. You see the website and...
Yes, yes.
Okay, okay. So I enlarge this view to compare the different times. So this was the first examination, which was presented in the video, the right lobe transverse longitudinal scan and the intact left lobe. I don't know, but I 4 weeks later, these are the images which were recorded 4 weeks later. The right lobe, the extent of the hypoechoic areas increased in the right lobe, and similar hypoechoic lesions appeared in the left one. The difference between this and this images is 4 weeks. And the last image was recorded 2 years later, so this was the fourth row of images. And you can see that the right lobe is almost intact, not fully, but almost intact, and the degree of hypoechogenicity has significantly decreased even in the left lobe. So your question relied whether this was a unilateral disease. Yes, at the first appearance, the thyroiditis affected only the right lobe. 4 weeks later also the left lobe became affected. This is a very specific and this rapid change is very specific of subacute thyroiditis. Hashimoto's thyroiditis cannot change over weeks. It is a quite stable disease. It can also change in the event of postpartum thyroiditis, but in no other condition it is imaginable that within weeks or months such great change could be observed in Hashimoto's case. This was a subacute case. Is it clear?
Thank you. It was interesting. Thank you.
Okay.